Hello and welcome to another video about Terra. In this one I will talk about guilds, how to create a guild, how to level it up and more. Let's get right into it. In order to make a new guild, you'll have to be at least level 8 and you'll need 100 gold. You also have to be in a party with at least one more person. Obviously, both of you cannot be in a guild while trying to create a new one, and you cannot be on cooldown for recently leaving a guild. Make sure there are at least two characters in the guild at all times. The guild will automatically disband if there is only one character left. Creating a guild can be done in the guild window. To add a guild emblem, the guildmaster has to save the image at the location you see on the screen right now, and then talk to Leonard in Velika Consul office. The image has to be a 64x64 pixel, 24-bit BMP file. Guilds can level up by completing guild quests or by leveling characters that are members. Each level up will give one point that can be spent on guild skills. There is also a list of the top 100 highest level guilds, however new ones might have to grind for a long time to even register in this list nowadays. As I just mentioned, leveling up the guild gives points which can be spent on guild skills. There are skills which increase the members' base stats, such as power, crit factor, HP or MP. But there are also skills that give temporary PvP buffs or let the guildmaster summon the guild members. The guildmaster can choose new skills in the guild skill tab of the guild window. There are 5 different quests the guild can do. In order to complete them, somebody just has to accept the quest, and then each time a guild member fulfills the requirement, the guild quest advances. For example, there is a guild quest for killing boss monsters. If this quest is active and a guild member runs a dungeon of any level, then the guild quest progresses every time the member's party kills a boss in that dungeon. If two people run a dungeon together, then every time the party kills a boss, the quest progresses twice. There are also quests for hunting regular mobs, winning in battlegrounds, gathering resources, and fishing. All of the quests can be accepted at the same time, but each one has a 12-hour timer. It has to be completed within those 12 hours, else the quest fails. Luckily, there is no penalty for failing, except for losing the quest progress. Once a quest is complete, somebody has to click on the complete button, which then gives the guild the experience points, veteran tokens, and guild funds. Every guild member can accept quests, but only members with the permission can cancel them. There really is no reason to cancel quests anymore though, since there is no penalty for failing them. The Valderon tokens reset every week on Sunday, and each guild can only complete guild quests until the Valderon tokens are maxed out. Completing guild quests earns the guild Valderon tokens. Once the guild reaches a certain amount, each guild member can claim a chest box that gives a couple of gems and some consumables. There are 3 chests the guild can earn each week. There are 2 different limits on the number of members that can be in the guild at any time. There is a limit of 300 characters, and by default there is also a limit of 100 accounts. This means that theoretically each player in the guild can join on 3 characters. There is, however, also a guild skill that can increase the amount of accounts that can join, while the 300 character limit cannot be increased. Most people will only have one character join the guild, so usually the account limit will be reached first. Due to these limits, the guildmaster will have to kick inactive players on a regular basis, in order to make space for new, active members. If there are people in the guild who join on multiple characters, you might want to ask them to write something in the personal introduction in the guild members tab, so everybody in the guild can see which characters belong together. There are cooldowns for leaving and joining guilds. After leaving a guild, you cannot join another one for 24 hours. Earlier I said that any guild member can accept guild quests, however this is not true in the first week after joining. It is also not possible to participate in civil unrest during the first week. In the Members tab you can see a small icon next to the names of new members, which indicates this cooldown. At the same time, the new guild members who are still affected cannot claim the chest boxes from Valderon tokens either. The guildmaster can create and name up to 30 ranks with different rights. There are 7 rights that can be given to each rank. The first right is managing member applications, which allows people with that rank to invite others to the guild and accept or decline applications. Next we have full guild bank access, which allows members to take items and gold from the guild bank. There is also the guild message right, which allows changing the message of the day, which shows up in your guild chat when you log in. The advertise guild right allows the use of the guild advertisement channel. Then there's the right to cancel guild quests, and the one for buying items in the guild shop. Finally, we have the right to declare and surrender to guild versus guild battles. There is a guild bank which is shared for all guild members. Each member can deposit items and gold, but they can only take items or gold if they have the permission to do so. Some items cannot be traded, but can be stored in the guild bank. Intelligence reports are one example. There are also items that cannot be stored in here. It is best to not put too much gold in the guild bank and only give full access to people who seem to be trustworthy. It is not unheard of people just looting the guild bank and then leaving, so it's best to reduce the risk of this happening and to make sure that the value of the guild bank does not increase too much. In my guild, anybody can ask for items they see in the guild bank, but not everybody has access. So when I give somebody the right to take items from the guild bank, I tell them that they can take items as they please, but they should also put other items back later. You might find card fragments in the guild bank, see a couple you still need, and take them. A few days later you might get card fragments you don't need, and put those in the guild bank instead. If you look at the first page of the guild window, you can also see who took items and who put items in. Members who have full access to the guild bank are also supposed to distribute items to members without full access, if needed. If you look at the Members tab in the guild window, you will notice that there are contribution points listed behind each name. Every character can earn up to 1000 contribution points per week, by either leveling up while in the guild, or by advancing guild quests. The contribution points show others that you helped leveling the guild during that week, and determine what share of the guild funds you get, in case the guildmaster decides to distribute some. As I mentioned earlier, every time a guild quest is completed, the guild earns funds. These funds can be used to declare war on other guilds, or surrender if another guild declared war. Using the guild skills that temporarily increase PvP attack and defense, or the guild member's summon skill, also cost guild funds on each use. Finally, each week the guildmaster can also distribute part of the funds in form of gold to guild members who gain contribution points during that week. To initiate a guild war, you need to have the right to manage guild versus guild battles. To start a war, you open the guild window and go to guild versus guild battles. Then you click on declare a GVG battle, which should open a new window. You then enter the name of the guild you want to attack, and click on the declare button on the bottom. Just above the declare button, you can see how many guild funds the declaration will cost. You can also see the rules for guild wars in the declaration window. The attacking guild will get charged funds over time to keep the battle going, unless the defending guild declares mutual war. Be aware though that while you're in a war with another guild, any of your guild members can be attacked. When it comes to open world, only Valleca is a safe zone. Guild versus guild fights are allowed in all other cities and towns. After starting a battle, the guild window will show you how many kills each guild got so far. The war only ends when the attacking guild withdraws or runs out of guild funds, or when the defending guild surrenders. Well, that concludes my video about guilds. Is there anything I forgot to add? Do you have any questions? Let me know in the comments below. Leave a like if this video was helpful and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!